Welcome to the Kendall Isaacs Gymnasium and welcome to 10YS TV. This is the GSSSA Junior Girls Basketball Championship Series. It could be championship day for four of our teams if they are able to close out the series in two games. On the other side, you have a set of teams looking to extend these series and extend their seasons for another game. CH Reeves Raptors, number two seed in the junior girls bracket, they took game one in convincing fashion over the top seeded HO Nash Lions, and that was thanks to 43 points from Tajaniqua Morley. Morley, number one for the Raptors, was unstoppable in game one. And already head coach Patty Johnson calls a timeout just 14 seconds into the first quarter. Not pleased with how her team defended Morley in game one. Let's see what adjustments they make for game two. Out of the early timeout, Frazier will inbound for the Lions. Gets it inside to Moxie. Nearly tied up. Rule picks up the loose ball. And stolen by Morley. The first of what will probably be many fast breaks for Morley, but she misses. Rebounded by Janae Bain, and she is fouled. Bain inbounds it, gets it over to Andronique Smith, and Smith gets it into the hands of Morley. Morley inside, oh good. Smith on the drive, her floater's no good. Battle for the rebound, still with C.A. Trias, third shot opportunity. Morley now misses, and H.O. Nash finally comes down with the board. Here's Frazier. Moxie hustling with Poitier for the rebound. And possession arrow will stay here with H.O. Nash. Pettigan had a team-high 18 in game one, scores the first basket of game two. Smith has it knocked away, stays here with the Raptors. Morley, jumper. Her first field goal of the game ties it up early. Tajaniqua Morley outscored the Lions by herself in game one, 43-42. And here she is on the break. No Lions back protecting the break. Layup line for Morley, but she blows the easy fast break layup. Pettigan goes to Frazier. Frazier's jumper off the mark. Moxie in there for the board. Her putback is no good, but she is much more active than she was in game one. Didn't get her first field goal until the third quarter in game one, but already has two shot attempts here in the first quarter. There she is again on the boards, but can't control. Rebound goes to Poitier. Looking to get it ahead to Morley, but Lions in the passing lanes. Pettigan on the drive. Contact. Morley picks up the loose ball, steps through. Layup is good, counted for Tajaniqua Morley. She has four, the Raptors have four. Bain gets the rebound, leading the break. Skip pass to Smith, and she will be fouled by Moxie. Frazier on the drive. Shepherd's putback is no good. Morley comes up with the board. Crosses over one defender, crosses over two defenders to the cup, and she scores. Again, the Lions already having problems stopping Morley in transition, and here she is again. Even when they get back in transition, she pulls up for a jumper. She has eight. Frazier's three is no good. Gets her own rebound. Misses the runner. So now two defenders shadowing Morley. They get it to Smith. Frazier first to the ground for the Lions. Tied up, ball will go to the Raptors. Bain tries to go inside the Poitier, stolen by Frazier. Canton unable to control that one in the front court. Out of bounds. Ball goes over to the Lions. Pettigan loses the handle, gets it over to Frazier. Her jumper is off. Rebound goes to Poitier, has Morley on the break, but dribbles it off of her foot. Out of the timeout, Lions go to Pettigan. She drives baseline, tries to kick it out for Edgecombe. Pettigan again driving left. Frazier along the baseline now. Tied up. Ball will stay with the Lions. Pettigan, no good. They get it to Morley. She picks it up and finds her way to the free throw line again. So the same traits from game one have carried over here to game two. Morley has done it on the break. She's done it shooting jumpers. And here she is with her first trip to the line. She has all eight for the Raptors. And her first free throw just rims out. Second free throw rims out. Lions get the board. Pettigan pushing it. Less than 10 seconds left. And Bain steals it. That is how our first quarter ends. Raptors lead 8-2, looking to close it out in two games against the Lions. Bain looking to inbound. They get it over to Poitier. Inbound play. They got the look that they wanted. Moxie the other way for the Lions. Too hard off the glass. Rebound goes to Poitier. Trapped in the backcourt. Frazier steals it. Bain with the foul, and Frazier will shoot two. Frazier misses both, but a lane violation. Gets her a third crack at it. No good. Lane violation the other way. Ball goes to the Raptors. So the Lions have denied Morley to get a touch on the last few possessions, and they do so here again. As long as they keep it out of her hands, the Lions are doing well defensively. Haven't been able to convert. Pettigan just puts her head down. Drives in to the defenders, jump ball. Possession arrow stays here. Stolen by Bain. And now they finally get it into the hands of Morley. Layup is off. Rebound goes to Canton. No good. Lions on the break the other way. 2-on-2. Frazier takes it herself. Smith gets in the way of that one. Turnover back to H.O. Nash. Back to C.H. Reeves, sorry. Finally, we get a score here in the second quarter. Morley tipped away, but jump ball, tied up. Raptors maintain possession. Shot waved off, foul called on the floor. Bane inbounds it to Smith. Steps on the sideline, so this turnover prone second quarter continues for both teams. Frazier pulls up for a transition three and banks it in. Morley now looking for the response, pushed, fouled, goes back to the line. Frazier struggled for most of game one with the game out of reach, started to connect from long range, getting into the act earlier here in game two. Lions trailed by just one. Morley now in double figures with 10. Raptors lead by 3. Pettigan called for the offensive foul. Lowered her shoulder one too many times, driving into the defender. Bane gets it into Poitier. 3 defenders following Morley. And the Lions come away with the steal. Poitier looking to take it back. Side to Moxie, no good. Frazier with the rebound. Moxie again. Moxie banks in the second free throw. stolen by Bain. Frazier for three. Makes her second of the game. Jada Frazier gives H.O. Nash their first lead. Morley tripped up again. Again, cut off by Morley. Kicks it out to Frazier again. Three is no good this time. Rebound goes to Morley. Count the basket and one. Once the Raptors get the ball to Morley, good things usually happen. Once they try something else, it's generally been a turnover all afternoon. Morley now with all 15 of the CH Reeves points, and they lead by four. Frazier blocked. Possession arrow goes over. To the Lions, trailing by four with 2:28 left to play. Controlling for the Raptors, gets it to Morley, and she's fouled again. With that foul, the Raptors are in the bonus, and H.O. Nash puts a obviously great free throw shooter on the line. And that is three fouls on Pettigan. One of the offensive leaders for this H.O. Nash team, so we love to see how they manage her foul trouble. Marley splits that pair. Edgecombe gets the board. Pettigan whistled for a travel. Mm-hmm. And that's the first basket for another Raptors player other than Morley. Canton's layup gives them a 18-11 lead. Frazier with the score, hoop and the harm. She goes to the line with an opportunity for a three-point play. Taking another look at it. Jada Frazier with the rebound and the putback. Lions call time. Out of the timeout, Frazier looks to convert the three-point play and cut into this C.H. Reeves lead. Frazier, no good. Long rebound goes to Edgecombe. Morley gets in the passing lane, but Pettigan comes up with a loose ball. They whistle Smith for the foul. Lions now in the bonus. Pettigan shoots two. Whistled for the travel. Ball stays here with H.O. Nash. Frazier on the inbound. .3 seconds left in the half. Lions will get possession. Frazier. Pettigan puts up a three at the buzzer. No good. C.H. Reeves lead by 5 headed into the half. Third quarter action underway. Raptors get it over to Poitier. No good. Canton with the rebound and the putback. Morley has 16. She has the other four for the Raptors, and the lead now up to 7. Hedigan drives. No good. Bain with the board, but trapped under the basket, gets it out. Stolen by Frazier. Her layup is good. Lions again defensively hounding Morley in the backcourt. Oxy rebounds the wild jumper from Frazier and puts it in. Lions trail by just 3 now. Morley finally gets her hands on it. Frazier steps into another 3, rebounded by Edgecombe. Petkin on the drive, puts up a wild one, no good. Morley hit and fouled again. Lions definitely being more physical with her here in game 2. Smith. And she is fouled. Timeout, Lions continuing to chip away at it. Smith, jumper, and Moxie is whistled for the over-the-back foul. And that's now 4 on her. So foul trouble for 2 key members of this Lions squad. That's 3 on Pettigan and 4 on Moxie. Johnson elects to let them play through it. Smith called for the travel. Mm-hmm.
And Pettigan will go to the line to shoot two.
And the Raptors already in the bonus with 3:28 left to play in the third. So they will be shooting free throws for the bulk of the third quarter. Morley misses both, but Poitier there for the rebound. Morley on the break, misses the layup. Smith there for the rebound and gets it back to her. Runner is no good, and now Poitier boards it. Ball out of bounds, will go back to the Lions. The rebound. They get it to Morley. Poitier well ahead of the field. Morley doesn't give it to her. She takes it herself. Puts the Raptors back up five. Morley again on the break, fouled from behind, and she will go back to the line. So not on pace for the 43 she had in game one. Slow day for her with just 18. But still outscoring the H.O. Nash Lions. Makes both free throws. Frazier steps into a three, off the mark, rebounded by Edgecombe, goes inside to Moxie, who's fouled. Count it, Shinobia Moxie. Can't get
the rebound. Loose ball goes to the Lions. Frazier again for three. No good. Raptors called for time. Under 2 minutes left to play in the third. And Pettigan fouls Morley before the inbound. And that should be number four. Yes, that is number four on her. So both Moxie and Pettigan with four fouls for the Lions. And this is not the player that you want to send to the free throw line when you're trying to get back into a game. Morley again makes them both. Frazier off the mark. Rebound into the hands of Morley. Stumbles and loses the handle. Ball will go over to the Lions. Shepherd takes a deep three. No good. Morley with the rebound. Frazier again for three. No good. Moxie with the board, but loses the handle. Trying to gather and go up for the putback. Bain gets it into Smith. Smith scores another two for the Raptors. Lead up to nine here in the closing moments of the third. Morley ties it up and gets a possession for the Raptors, looking to push this lead to double digits now. 36 seconds left in the quarter. Smith floats a pass. Can't get it to Morley, but knocks out of bounds by the Lions. Morley resets, looking to hold for the last shot. 8 seconds left, and Shepard steals it away. And Morley will be whistled for the foul. And the Lions call the timeout to draw up one final play here in the quarter. Inbound goes to Frazier. 2 seconds left. Heaves one up at the buzzer. No good. Raptors lead 28-19 headed into the fourth. Six minutes left. Do the Raptors claim back-to-back titles, or do the Lions have one final run to extend their season and force a third and deciding game? Three shot opportunities for the Lions. They come up empty. Boarded by Morley. She goes behind the back. Loses the handle, stolen by Pettigan. Smith with the foul. Thank you.
No good on the first from Pettigan. Baines saves it, but over to the Lions. Frazier on the drive, and she is fouled. Morley on the break, no good. Gets the loose ball, her putback is no good. Poitier, four shots for the Raptors. Back into the hands of Morley. Pulls up for the J. Off the back iron, rebound goes to Moxie. Morley tracks it down. As it tipped away, jumper. Frazier just heaves one. Pettigan drives, no good. Moxie fouled. Banks in both free throws, lead trimmed back down to single digits. Moxie on the drive, gets by all the defenders and lays in another one. Every time the Lions trim this deficit, she has had the answer for C.H. Reeves. Morley goes back to the line. Raptors nursing this 8-point lead. Inside they go to Moxie again. But again, no answer for Morley in transition. Lions scoring, but they have to get stops. Under the 3-minute mark now, time running out in this game and on their season. Payne inbounds it to Morley. Roll giving chase. And roll with the foul. And Morley has been hit to the ground almost as many times as she has points in this game. Slow to get up. Foul called on the floor, Bain to inbound. Raptors can't control it. Lions with another opportunity to trim into this deficit even further. They've got to hurry. Pettigan controlling, gets it to the front court. Frazier on the drive, no good. And that's number 5 on Frazier, so she has fouled out.
Moxie has been working inside here in this fourth quarter. No good on the free throw. Is it too little too late for the Lions? Bain comes away with the loose ball, and Kenton wide open down the floor. Unable to come up with the pass. Pettigan, three. Long rebound goes to Shepherd. Over to Moxie on the drive. And she scores two, lead now down to six. 1:23 left to play. Pettigan makes one, lead is now five. Possession arrow stays here with the Lions. Moxie loses the handle. And Poitier comes up with a loose ball. On the break, she is fouled. Brianna Poitier at the line, shooting two. Lions' faint hopes still alive as she misses both. But now this loose ball stays here with the Raptors. Bane tying it up and earning another possession for C.H. Reeves after the two missed free throws. Goes inside, and that could do it. Bane with the assist to Canton. 7-point lead. Stolen by Bain. And she is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. Seconds left. Lions down eight. And Moxie called for a double dribble. The Raptors fan base now beginning to celebrate. 19.5 seconds away from back-to-back titles. Bain inbounds it to Canton. And she turns it over. Moxie on the drive. Bain heaves it ahead. And Edgecombe comes up with the steal. But Morley is there, fouled, puts one up, and gets it to go. Tajaniqua Morley puts an exclamation mark on this game and on this series and on her clear-cut MVP performance. Morley has dominated both games and gives the Raptors a 9-point lead, 7.2 seconds left. Kattigan fouled. And with 0.2 seconds remaining on the clock, misses both. That'll do it. CH Reeves Raptors back-to-back GSSSA Junior Girls Champions.